And on the red side, it's the GPL's Taipei Assassin with Archie in the top lane.
Onto her and make it very hard to lane.
I think this pick and ban phase was extraordinary. Winds is up in the top lane trying to set up a gank. If Dyrus can withstand this right here and not give up a kill, it's going to be very good for Amazing and TSM. But he gets in without being interrupted by the tornado.
One of the lockdowns onto Turtle. We talked about having not that many escapes. Lost Boy can only provide a bit to disengage. Dyrus doesn't know that Winds is in the brush. Control from TPA here to the top lane, but Amazing
nice
in the back pocket. He gets the cripple down. He's able to lock it. It's Archie going down for first blood, and they could get wins here. Flame Spitter out, but they're gonna back off.
Just up bottom lane, he knows that's warded, so he's gonna try delayed entrance right here. It's almost impossible to gank for John.
Oh, and he lands it! Oh, what a flash coming out. Beautiful job by BB, but also a great.
I like to play some pink wards, but we also see them just leave them. They want to defend this one.
Very scary for Amazing. Just gets himself out to a safeguard, almost stunned up. Morning keeps himself going strong on this.
His wards have been burned out. Is just begging for a counterattack. Great move there by TPA.
Yeah, and while we were talking about TSM potentially setting up for the dragon here with the Rombo.
Man is teleporting in.
Suddenly
stop
TPA will get
Archie.
It. Instantly stop. Let's see what's gonna happen. Bjergsen's the only guy here. Animation joining in.
With the ultimate, wins very low. Bjergsen's gonna find the ultimate kill.
Well, that
turned around in the top lane. The polymorph was down. Dyrus was able to go full damage even after the wild growth was used through Archie. And what a
double
play
kill
going
in the bottom lane as well.
Boy, what?
Yet. Oh my god.
Still going on to Morning. He gets the sombrero to work on Amazing, but
happened?
It's one quick shot from Bjergsen. They are really heating things up.
Challenge to production, we need about three replays right there.
Go on, you don't actually take
it
damage.
Let's just see
the replay.
We're gonna try and recreate what happened here. So obviously he flashed to stop the teleport, but that just made him walk into the level advantage. That was Dyrus.
Great
equalizer. So Dyrus pulled that off. Now we get the bottom lane. Deficio take this one.
Well, there's not a lot to say, actually. The fight is already over here. Lost White, I just saw it on my other screen before here. He managed to actually flash behind BB and ult him backwards. And Dyrus, as soon as he saw an opening, he would go for the kill down bottom lane as well. The 2v2 fight. We keep talking about how Lost White and Wild Turtle have been poor. Amazing, though, you're in trouble.
That's going to be a problem. Dyrus getting himself into a sticky situation. Winds just got up. Will he go down? He gets the shield, and he will stay alive. Dyrus throws down the scrap shield, and he gets the movement speed necessary. A quick dodge on the Zenith Blade. He's trying to get away, but the sun way too hot as Jay helps to pick up that kill.
Is very
weird.
Peculiar to me.
Oh, got that warning symbol. They want Amazing, the playmaker right now, really helping out the team. Dyrus could throw down a red carpet. It's right across them. Jay gets locked up pretty hard, but the damage really is not following through just yet. BB hops over the wall looking for a reset to get back to safety, or with help from the rest of the team, they are backing off. A lot of ultimates are still up.
It seems like TK don't really want to challenge. You don't want to walk.
Explosive shot on, but Jay's actually forced to back up. He knows he's squishy as well, and the rest of the team is not ready to engage on this. Morning taking poke. He's already below half. Could it be the ball?
Oh, no!
He's like one in there. Amazing got hit up. The heal comes out quickly, and they turn this fight right around. Jay finally gets in. The red carpet gets laid out, and they're going to welcome them to the party. Dyrus, he gets untargeted with the Zanyas. But can they continue the fight? There's no minions. They're stepping a little close here, guys. There come the ultimates. One last shot. Archie dodges close, and he dodges the right way.
TSM just can't seem to finish these kills. One part about not having the big initiation and just the poke, they have to close. There's one.
One indeed, Jat. Turtle taking a lot of shots here. There's no re-engage you're going to be seeing. Way too low.
Yona, it's not exactly like they have a good siege-breaking team. They're going to try right here. The wind's in a pick board.
They throw out the Howling Gale. He gets shut down immediately. Last time he's going to be doing that. Nice shots coming in. Wild Turtle almost able to finish that off with the ult.
Good vision control. That's been Wind's arch nemesis this game, has been those wards. And it takes him down yet again. Costs TPA an inhibitor. Jay goes low as well.
Baron going over to team solo mid. This may be what they need to finalize the game. TPA
will join in. Notice Jay on your minimap. He's already flanking around. They want
to
go
now.
They want
another pick ward.
Jay gonna be looking for a solar flare. It locks down Dyrus, but he's already got the equalizer damage out. Zanya's across the board. You're looking good, gentlemen. They go for the inhibitor turret now. It's 11-4, and TSM's gonna be looking to get a lot more kills as they pressure down on the Nexus turret.
Just no good initiation paths for TPA. TSM knew where they'd want to go, knew how they'd want to go about it.
Kog'Maw team is not flawed by any matter. You do need to be able to kill them quickly, but when you fall behind, it just makes it look pretty bad.
TSM
Looking to dodge another one on this. Pink Boy possibly going down. They do get the shockwave. Lustboy disengages the fight. Equalizer not hitting much. There is hardly any follow-up though from TPA. It's going to be a wait on the ultimate. The Sonic Wave hits, and he takes it all the way in. Amazing. Pushing back BB and Morning, and it's going to be the last inhibitor turret for Team Solomid if they want it.
I mean, finally TPA
2-1 on the group. A lot of people wondered what would happen in this match, and it's Team Solomid coming out with the victory.
By far the most controlled game that TSM has played so far here at Worlds. They had
no engage options from TPA because of so many wards being placed by TSM.
And it was definitely once they were able to pull ahead. I mean, it's something that's been true for TSM for so long. During the regular season, it was about their ability